I'd like to thank the families and the Barak for what they've organised here, because I think it's important. But to be honest, I've spoken on platforms like this far too many times. And when people talk about justice, I don't think we have a justice system. We have an injustice system. Because what actually happens is the people that carry out those attacks or carry out racist attacks, we're told if you go into one of those education institutions, they'll explain to you we live in a post-racist society and that racism has disappeared. And we've got politicians that come forward and say that it's fundamentally changed. But one aspect that consistently doesn't change is the deaths that take place inside custody, continued racist attacks. And what I'd like to say is that I want to pay tribute to the family's resistance against this, because I think it can be exposed. I went with ABBA, who called a demonstration in London against when Trayvon was murdered, to bring people together, and people did come together. And I think when we talk about what's going on now with the injustice system, when I grew up in London, you were 8 times more likely to be stopped and searched by the police. Today it's 43 times more likely to be stopped and searched by the police. I don't believe institutionally that racism's actually been pushed back. I think that many parts of the police and the injustice system continue to behave in the same way as they did before. Because how can you explain the delay when somebody is murdered for them to arrest the person that killed somebody? The family's already said it. If anybody believes that you killed, if I killed somebody in London, they'd leave you for several weeks to work out whether you did it or not. I don't believe that would happen. You'd be immediately arrested and you'd immediately targeted. And I believe what we have to understand about the justice system is that we have to understand about how it's changed. And I think the reason why it changed in America was because of the civil rights movement. The reason why it changed in Britain was because people like Dorian Lawrence brought together an alliance of people, trade unions, black and white, and said that we were going to resist what was going on. Because up until then, they didn't change. That's why when I was outside the court, when the two murderers were convicted of killing Stephen, the police came running out to say that it was their job, they're the reason why those people were brought to justice. And I'd like to say it's not. I think it's because the people sitting in this room, I think it's because people have resisted, and they say the police have changed, but look what they did to Jodie McIntyre on the demonstration. Look at Ian Tomlinson. The nature of our justice system is fundamentally wrong, and I'd say something else. I believe it's there to protect the rich and the powerful in British society, because they never have a problem. They've got an inquiry going on at the moment now called the Leveson Inquiry. And what does it tell you? Every single person at the top of society had a link into corruption. In fact, one of the people put an axe in the back of a policeman's head. Usually you kind of recognise something's kind of gone wrong there. Right? But this person isn't arrested or brought to justice. So I think today, the vigil today, the meeting today, is highlighting why we have injustice in society and why racism continues to be part of the centre of what goes on. And the way I would like to end this on is I think in a society that's in crisis, too often do we see the race card being played to tell people their problems are other people. And you know, you've seen what's happened. David Cameron said multiculturalism doesn't work. I'm not going to take lessons from somebody from Eton who's a millionaire and then says that your neighbour is the problem. The problem is we have a society that defends the rich and the powerful and encourages racism. That's why I'm proud to be on this platform with people that resist it. And I want to bring another message to say we should learn from Dorian Lawrence. They said a black working class woman couldn't take on the Met. Well, she did. And to be honest, I'm not saying she's completely broken them, but one of the things, the other message she's brought out is saying that she wants them done for corruption and racism. We should support that message. The fight against racism and the fight against injustice goes on. And I think the key to breaking that is solidarity. Solidarity is the key for doing that. When we stand together, we have a better chance of exposing those people that try and divide us. It's the mass demonstrations that made the president say in America that something has changed. And I think that's a little warning to us as well. The president is black. I remember listening to Tupac Shakur and various jazz people saying that, you know, that you'll never have a black president. We have got a black president. And I'm glad we've got, you know, whatever it is. But on the ground, I think what's more important is what we're doing now in terms of resisting and organising. We have to do that on a consistent basis to be able to do it. This is far beyond the remit of United Against Fascism. I'm not usually allowed to say any of these things because other people get very angry with me. But what I do want to say is that the problem is I'm too angry to wait and shut up and not say anything. And I think everybody that speaks out has a chance to expose injustice if we stand together in a united way. We've got a chance of challenging racism. That's why I'm sad at the loss of the two brothers. I'm sad at the loss that somebody so young loses their lives. But I'm actually proud that although those people are in grief, they've called for struggle and to take place. And I'll end up with one of my heroes, a man called John Carlos, who's come to speak in London on the 22nd. And he was asked, why did he raise his fist in the middle of the 68 Olympics? He said he raised that fist because it stood for resistance and it stood for unity. And I think that's the best way of dealing with those people that try and cover up murders and put people down. We should raise our fist and resist.